We are going to create a Google site for your professional learning log. After you log into your Google Mail account, you will notice that up in the top black bar, it will say Sites. You'll want to click on it. You should come up with an area that looks like this. You will have no sites here, as this will be your first site that you create. When I click on Create for a site, you will notice that a number of options come up on the top. We are going to leave the empty template as our option. You then will go ahead and give the specific name, which we will talk about during class. For right now, I'm just going to create something that looks like a test site. And then you get to have some fun by creating a theme that you want. And you will notice there are multiple themes that you can choose from. Remember, this is a professional site, so you want it to look like something that can be shown to future employers, future people who might be looking at to see if you can join their college. You want it to look professional. I like this one, so I'm going to choose Garden. When I click on Create, I will go ahead and wait for it to develop, and then you should be able to see your site that shows up. What you need to realize is that this site is live at this time, meaning we need to know that everything we put on here could be accessed by someone else. That's part of being a good digital citizen. On the front here, you are going to see a bunch of tabs up on the top. This tab right here is an edit page, so you will actually be able to go in and edit this part of your paper. This right here is to add a new page. In other words, right now we only have one page in our site. If we want to go add another one, that's where we go. This one's pretty important. This one is the More page. And the More page gives us a lot of different options. Number one, page setting. The template, in case we would want to change that, we don't want to. You could edit the site layout, and this is kind of a neat feature, and I'm going to go ahead and click on it. When we click the Edit the Page feature, you can decide where do I want the sidebar. Okay, now it's gone. Now it's back. Do I want horizontal navigation, which puts it up on the top? And if I want that, you will get that when you go ahead and change it. Do I want to talk about the header or not the header? There's different things that we can do here. Do we want a custom footer? Do we want that to go away? Either way, these are all options for us to choose, and we'll talk about it more in class. Going back to this, there are a couple of things here in the Manage Site that you want to take care of. You could give a description for your site, which would give you an opportunity to explain your site a little bit more. There are a couple of other items on here, sharing and permission. Right now, we are only having this located at Pulaski Community School District. But one thing that's really important is see how you can find and edit it. We want to change that. We don't want other people to edit our site. So we're just going to say that anyone with a link can take care of viewing this site. So we're going to click on Save. The site layout is important. The site layout, that gives you an opportunity to change maybe a logo on top. And we're not really going to do a whole lot of that stuff right this moment. The colors and fonts are kind of fun. You can go ahead and change the colors. Even though I have the garden theme, I could decide that I want a different background page. I could background color, so I could go ahead and change that background color like this. And that can be a nice way for you to go ahead and customize it. I can click on background image. We're not going to probably do an image right now. Then you can decide what kind of font you want, and if I customize it, you can choose whatever font you want that will make your site look good. You can do page link color, so in other words, when people click on a link, you can decide what color you want. Notice there are multiple ideas. We can go on and on and on, and we're going to give you a few minutes to take care of looking at that. But that's certainly something that you can go ahead and do. So when we get done with all that, we save it. And then when to get back to our site, we go ahead and get back to our site. And you can see now that my site has changed due to the colors that I want. So how do we go ahead and edit a page? We go ahead and click on edit a page, and up here we are going to type the items that we are going to include in our writing for the year. Once we have those, we can make them links by highlighting them and using the links option up here. You can do really anything in Word that you've done before on a Word document up here. We go ahead and click on save, and now we have our site. If you want people to get to your site, this is your site address.